Yeah, real talk. Well, J Mad, he gotcha. Right here doing God's work, bringing life after the collar. Hey, radio show, and he's doing it big. You just can't ignore J Mad, bringing you the word. Just holler at your boy. Hey, life after the collar with J Mad.
This is your boy J Mad, and this is your motivational moment. We got 10 minutes to just hang out with you for a second. Enjoy this jam, and we're going to be all good. We're going to be all gravy. Holla at your boy. Good morning, y'all. If you're listening to me live, you are listening to J Mad, the host of Life After the Collar. This is your motivational moment. When I woke up this morning, I had so much energy on the inside. Matter of fact, I'll redefine it as I've had so much love on the inside. I don't know, for whatever reason, that it came to me this morning, but I'm going to be honest with you. I was so much in love with myself. I don't know if you ever have felt that way before, but this morning, I was in love with Jason. I was in love with J-Man. Matter of fact, I'll put it the way I originally said it. I was in love with Jason. It had absolutely nothing to do with J-Mad. It had nothing to do with elder, pastor, overseer, none of those titles. It had everything to do with Jason. It's been years since I've been able to say that I love Jason. A lot of decisions we make in life is based on how we love ourselves. They're not mistakes. They're just bad decisions that we've made. We've connected with people. We've connected with organizations. We've connected with different situations, all based on how we feel about ourselves. The Word of God simply tells us this. that we are to love others as we love ourselves. If that be the truth, that's exactly what we're doing in life. We're loving others, and we are allowing others in our personal space based on how we love ourselves. I read a comment yesterday on Facebook. I think it was Facebook or Instagram, but it was really good. It said, told the enemy, today is not your day to be messing with me. I'm paraphrasing it. Today is not your day to be messing with me or coming at me, and tomorrow ain't looking good for you either. That's the space that I'm in right now. That's the space that I am. I'm loving life. I am where I am. I'm doing what I'm doing, all because I'm in a place where I love myself. There's a song that I actually love, and it reminds me of when you know that first type of connect something with somebody that got your mind, and they're consuming all of your thoughts. The name of the song is "Get Back to My Babe" by Vivian Green. That's a great song, and I love it. And when I play it, especially when it first came out, I used to love that song. And now you can attach that person, okay, you know, that song to the person. But I was playing it and I was listening to it. Get right back to my babe. You know who my babe is right now? When I woke up this morning, I was my own baby. I loved on my own self. I looked in the mirror and said, you know what, Jason? I love you. When was the last time you looked in the mirror and told yourself that you loved you? If you want to get to the next step in life, and you want to get to a place where you're making sound decisions and decisions based on where you want to be and where you want to go, it all starts with loving yourself. There's no other advice. There's no other motivation that I can say from any other motivational things that I go from here. It's going to be built on this conversation right here. Loving on yourself. When you love on yourself, the people that you connect with, the jobs that you go to, the events that you go to, the things that you do is going to be simply based on, do you love you? No ifs, you know my line, no ifs, no ands, no buts about it. Start loving on you. Start being you. Start embracing you. If your dress style is different, let it be different. If what you want to do in life is different than the norm, let that be you. Yesterday, I was getting some music together, and I came across so many, which was unheard of, but they got some good music. It's rarely heard of. I ran across a lot of black country singers, and I just started, because I love country music too, and I just started downloading their music, and I was like, wow, this is some good stuff. But I can only imagine what a challenge it is that they had to go through in order to get into the ministry, into the industry, based on their color of their skin. But it was something that they had to be passionate about in order to go through. Thank you, God. Thank you for showing me that. When you love yourself, there's a passion that builds on the inside of you. And no matter what you come against, because you love you and because you love the way God has built you, you're going to understand one thing. That no matter what I go through or what I have to go through, I can withstand it. Why? Because I love me. I believe in me. Other people going to misunderstand you. That's just the way it is. People going to misunderstand your love. People are going to misunderstand your thought process. People are going to misunderstand your dream. But in the end of the night, you're going to have something to hold on to, because you got yourself in your own hands. Learn to love on you. Learn to love on you and get right back to you. Get back right to your babe, which is you. This is your boy, J-Mab, host of Life After the Collar. And I just wanted to give you a motivational moment. We had a good time last night. If you missed last night's show, it was so good. I ended up having to do it in two parts. So if you go on Spreaker.com/show/LATC, you'll be able to get to the shows, all of my episodes. I did go back and change it. But last night's shows were so good. You're going to enjoy it. I promise you, you will enjoy it. Two different shows I had to do because we had some technical difficulties. The second show, you can actually bypass the first two songs and get back into the conversation, because what happened was, even when we came back on air, we still had some problems with the mic. So we just skipped the first two songs because you'll hear echo in the songs. So what we'll do, just if you listen to it again, go on in the second episode, go past the first two songs and get back into the conversation, and everything was fixed and we was all gravy. All right. This is Vivian Green I was just talking about. I got to get right back to my babe. It's going out to all of y'all. Get back to loving you, because that's where I am. When I woke up this morning, that's why I had so much love in my heart. Get back to loving you. Holla at your boy. This is J-Man. Love you.
About is you, and now I'm looking at the J-Mad is not your everyday lunch partner. He's all the way raw.
How are you going to say Black Lives Matter when the only reason you come out is when cops kill us and we don't come out when we kill ourselves? That's crazy, man.
He's all the way real.
The truth? You can't even handle the truth.
And most of all, he has his priorities right.
I want the Falcons and the Hawks to be my pallbearers at my funeral. That way they can let me down just one last time.
J-Mad gives it to you big.